Hello, everyone. After months and months and months of talking about this, I have finally made a YouTube channel. My first video is going to be 5 steps to creating epic, dramatic, whatever you want to call them, self-portraits in nature, a landscape scene, using a wide-angle lens. I'm saying a wide-angle lens because that is what I use the most, so therefore I have the most experience using it. I shoot with a 16-35, and I often use 16, or I also use 35. So I do want to mention that this is going to be about self-portraits, but you could apply all of these steps to, say, if you were just shooting a model, and you'll also notice that I use a lot of dresses. It's actually all I wear is a dress, but you could wear pants, you could wear a jacket. Pretty much all of these tips apply to anything that involves using a human in a landscape setting. Step number one, and I think that this is the most important of them all. It is all about confidence. You need to be confident if you are going to put yourself out there in awkward situations, photographing yourself in a self-portrait. You really, really have to love yourself. If you don't love yourself, you will spend so much time taking hundreds and hundreds of photos, picking yourself apart, and that is just no good for anybody. In reality, we don't always like everything about ourselves. I don't like my stomach, so usually I'm trying to hide that in my self-portraits, but I think I have really great hair. It's really, really long. It's really dark. I am also slightly curvy, so I try to use these in all of my self-portraits. You'll notice I always have my hair out. It's always down. I'm always using it in the wind. I love it, and I try to work it. Step number two is all about having the right gear. You don't need to have the best gear, but there are some items that are going to make your life a lot simpler to photograph a self-portrait. Obviously, a camera and a lens. I typically use a wide-angle lens, a 16-35, so I'll talk about that the most throughout this video, but you can use any lens. You can use a zoom, you can use a prime, you can use a wide, whatever your heart desires. They will all do the same thing. They'll just look different at different focal lengths. Secondly, and most importantly, is a tripod. You can try to use a rock outside or a chair if for some random reason you have a chair, or you can even use the ground. This is going to be annoying though, and you're going to struggle, so honestly, just get a tripod. You can get pretty cheap ones if you don't have one. You don't have to spend a lot of money. You will need some sort of remote to help you take these images. You can use a shutter release, you can use an app on your phone that connects to your camera, or you could even use the 10-second self-timer. If you decide to use a shutter release, which I use this method quite a bit, you can set your camera into continuous shooting, you can lock your remote, and then this way, you're able to walk out and get a variety of images. So you can pick the best pose. If you're wearing a dress, you can pick the best dress movement or the best hair movement. You'll have multiple photos to choose from, and this is a really cool option because you have so many choices. Most recently, I have been using the Canon remote app on my phone. I personally love this method the best. It does have its flaws, but it has many great perks. If you're using the app, you can actually see yourself while you're taking the image, and this helps so much with posing. The biggest downfall I find of using the app is that your hands are most likely going to be showing in your self-portrait, so this doesn't really leave you any options of where to put your phone. If I'm facing away from the camera, I just kind of tuck it in the front of my dress. But if I'm facing the camera or I'm facing to the side, I find I have to either tuck it in some sort of a pocket if what I'm wearing has a pocket, or just hide it the best way I can. Or worst case scenario, you could just Photoshop it out, but that to me is just kind of annoying. So that is the biggest downfall of using your phone as a remote. Step number three. This is all about posing, and posing to me also falls along the same lines as having confidence. So a few things to look out for are your limbs. Try to keep your limbs away from your body as much as possible. Don't have them out like this, but just slightly have them away from your body. If you have your limbs close to your body, this is going to make you look bigger and just kind of make you look like a blob. If you have them apart, your legs or your arms, you'll just create some space in between your body and a good shape to your body. Also, if you have really, really long hair, like me, I highly suggest letting it down and trying to let the wind pick it up, or if there's no wind, try to move it as best as possible. Any sort of movement in a photo just looks organic and it looks natural, especially with a dress. If it's windy and the wind is blowing in the right direction, this is amazing, and the best photos come from these situations. Try to stand to the side as much as possible, especially if there's any light coming in from the side of the frame. One of my favorite ways of posing is facing the light and having the light hit my face and the front of my body. I find that this creates a lot of depth. It looks good. It changes it up from just having your back facing the camera, and it's really, really flattering. Another way I like to pose is by sitting. So if there's a rock or the ground or whatever, I will try to sit as much as possible. One thing to keep in mind is to make sure your legs are somewhat showing. If you're wearing a dress, pull the dress up a little bit. Make sure you have bare feet, but if you have shoes, that's fine. And also point your toes, because this looks a lot better than a flexed foot. It looks more natural, it looks more elegant. Just try to show some legs. It looks good. If you are fully covered, you just kind of look like a little blob sitting there on a rock. Walking to and from the camera is a great way to get movement in a dress, get movement in your hair, and it also looks natural. I find that if you're walking, it just looks organic. You get the best poses that way. Even try running a little bit or try hopping. It looks really, really good, and it just adds to the photo a bit more than just standing there straight, just looking away into the distance. That can start to end up looking a little boring. Step number 4, choosing the right clothing options and matching colors to the landscape scene. I typically always wear a dress. I have worn a jacket before and just pants, but I'm usually in a dress. So this is something that I think is really, really important. You have to kind of color coordinate what you're doing. You should have a dress that complements the scene that you're photographing. I like to use a variety of colors. I try to think about the scene that I'll be in, and I try to pick a dress that really matches it. For example, I was recently just in Death Valley, and I was doing many, many self-portraits on the sand dunes. The sand dunes have a lot of yellow tones in it, and I thought that a purple dress was the best match for this. It popped, it looked great. Yellow and purple are complementary colors, and purple is actually a really hard color to use, so this was perfect. This was just a perfect place to use a purple dress. You guys may notice that I use a yellow dress a lot. I find that yellow is very versatile. It works in most scenes. It works in forests, lakes, up in the clouds. It really is a color that just complements every scene that I photographed, so I love using a yellow dress. I also love using a blue dress, but I try to save a blue dress for the winter time. I just find that it looks cool, it adds to the snow, it really pops against the snow, and it just gives you that chilly, cold feeling. And I live in Canada, and it's always chilly, and it seems like there's just snow 24/7. Another thing about clothing, and especially when wearing dresses, is picking the right sort of dress for your scene. So the more lacy, frilly, feminine the dress is, the more whimsical and fairy tale-like your image will look. Dresses are actually really, really expensive, and the more material that they have and the more intricate that they are, the more money it's going to be. So I highly recommend hitting up thrift stores, getting old wedding dresses, old bridesmaids' dresses, whatever you can find. Sometimes the uglier, the better. I don't know if that really makes sense, but the uglier it is. A little dress hack for you. To get some more material and more movement with your dress, cut a slit up the front of it. This will allow it to open and flow better, and you can also use the slit as a way to have your leg showing, which I think looks really, really elegant in images. Ollie says he thinks it looks elegant too. You're so cute, Ollie. You're so cute. Step number 5. This is all about composition, and we're going to be focusing on a wide angle lens because, again, that is what I shoot with the most. So I am a landscape photographer first before I was a self-portrait photographer. So my brain is usually always thinking about the landscape scene first, and then I'm adding myself into that somehow. One of the most important things to me in a landscape photograph is a foreground. A strong foreground leads you through the image, it leads you to the background, and in this case with self-portraits, it's going to lead you to yourself in the scene. Where you have the horizon line is quite important. Try not to cut off your neck, but I don't really find that if you have it kind of in the middle of your body or down by your legs, I don't really find that this looks funny at all. Just play around, and if it just somewhat is like, no, that doesn't look natural, don't put yourself there. I think the neck is the most important thing to not cut off in a composition. And if you're using a wide angle lens, try not to put yourself too close to the edges of the frame or to the top of the frame. With using a wide angle lens, you're going to distort yourself, so you might end up making yourself just look really, really big, or you're gonna end up making yourself look really, really tall. I sometimes push this with my vertical images where I'm a little bit too close to the top of the frame. I end up looking really, really tall, but one way that I fix that is I actually just liquefy the top of my head down in Photoshop. Since you are adding a human into this scene, try to really simplify your landscape scene. Just try not to have it too chaotic, stay away from mess. Less is usually more. And since you're gonna be in this image, this is a strong focal point of the image. So you really just wanna kind of draw the attention to yourself. I really, really hope that you guys find all these tips, steps useful, and I hope that it inspires you to get out there and create some self-portraits. I have been photographing my self-portrait since August of 2019, and it has been one of the best business decisions that I've made, and just for my own personal growth and adding to my own confidence, it has been absolutely wonderful. I love photographing self-portraits. I love combining the use of dresses and sort of that elegance with my landscape photography. I just plan on continuing doing more of them, and I hope that you guys follow along. If you really like this video and you just want to keep seeing more stuff from me, please subscribe and like this video. Get in the comments and tell me some stuff that you want to see, stuff that you want to learn from me. I feel my absolute best when I'm sharing my knowledge with you guys, and I hope to grow my own craft and grow my own skills so I can teach you more stuff, and you're winning and I'm winning and everybody is just having a great time. I am also open to constructive criticism if you have any tips for me with future videos or stuff that I can work on so I can improve with video, improve with audio, or just improve my presence in front of the camera. Feel free to let me know, hopefully in really, really nice ways because I am a little sensitive, but get on there, connect with me. I love talking with you guys. I will see you in the next video. Bye. All this says bye too. Bye.